الحسين عليه أفضل الصلاة والسلام. Imam Hussein عليه السلام, as we all know, is the second son of Imam Ali عليه السلام after Imam Hassan, and is the son of Fatima عليه السلام, daughter of the Prophet of Allah صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم, is the brother of Imam Hassan al-Mujtaba and brother of Zainab عليه السلام, and is father of the rest of the nine of the Ma'sumin عليهم السلام. So Imam Hussein has a special, even within Ahlul Bayt عليهم السلام, who are special, amongst them Imam Hussein is special. He is grandson of the Imam, he is son of the Imam, he is son of Fatima al-Zahra, Sayyidat Nisa al-Alameen, he is a brother of Imam, and he is a brother of father of nine of the Ma'sumin, alayhim salam, and he is with all this, it's make Imam Hussein even within the Imama, is brother of Zainab, of course, Umul Masaib. Within that Imama, Imam Hussein has a special position. His kunya is Abu Abdullah, and that's why in the ziyara we already say Ya Aba Abdullah, because his kunya is Abu Abdullah. As Abu and Abi, this is a grammatical rule where the word come. It could be Abu or Abi, depend on the position with the sentence. Just in case, say why you say Abu Abdullah. Titles, Imam Hussein has given many titles. The very famous one is Sayyid al-Shuhada. He's the master of the martyrs. He's the father of the Imams, Abu al-A'imma. He's the master of the youth of heaven, Sayyid Shabab Ahlil Jannah. He's a Sayyid, the master, Al-Rashid, the rational, the martyr, Al-Shaheed, the Al-Zaki, the pure, Al-Tayyib, the nice, pure, Al-Mubarak, from Barakah, Al-Sibt, the grandson, and the one who belongs to the pleasure of these last two. I'm going to comment on them towards the end of my talk, is التابع لمرضات الله, the one who belongs to the pleasure of Allah, and الدليل على ذات الله, the proof on the essence of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Imam Hussein عليه السلام was born in the 3rd of Sha'ban in the year 4th after Hijrah. His wife Shahrabano is mother of Imam Zain al-Abidin عليه السلام, Layla mother of Ali al-Akbar, and Rabab, the mother of Sakina, and Ali al-Asghar, alayhim as-salam. When Fatima, alayhi as-salam, was pregnant with Imam Hussein, alayhi as-salam, Umul Fadl, although Umul Fadl, the famous one, wife of Abbas, the prophet, uncle, she saw in her dream as a piece of the body of the prophet was separated from his body and get into the lap of Ummul Fadl. So she was shocked from this dream and went to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alayhi, and told him what she saw. The Prophet said, do not worry, this is a good news. Fatima alayhi salam will give birth and you will hold the newborn child in your lap. So she said that this is what happened afterwards when Fatima alayhi salam gave the birth, and Ummul Fadl, she picked the child and put it on her lap. The Prophet tells about the Shahada of Imam Hussein to be killed by his ummah, by his nation, even at the time of the wilada. Usually at the time of wilada of a person, people is a celebration day. But the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wa alihi, actually he's cried at the time of the birth of Imam Hussein. There is a narration of Imam Sadiq alayhi salam, said Jibra'il came down to the Prophet and said that you will be given the news of a newborn baby from Fatima. Your nation will kill him after you. Your ummah will kill him after you. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi said, the salam on my Lord, I don't need a boy that will be killed by my nation. Then Jibra'il alayhi salam, he came down again and said, in his progeny, will be the imamat, wilayat, and wasiyah. After that, the Prophet said, I agreed. Then after that, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi has given that news to Fatima alayhi salam initially, and she said the same thing. Initially, she said, I don't want that child. But when the Prophet said that it is the imamat, wilayat, and wasiyah in his progeny, then she accepted alayhi salam. The Prophet, as we said, cried on Imam Hussein when he was born. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi went into the house of Fatima and asked Asma to hand him the boy. Then he kissed him and cried. Asma, surprised, said, O Prophet of Allah, why you are crying? As she expected him to be happy having a new born grandson. He said, group from my nation will kill him. May Allah deny them my shafa'ah. Then he said to Asma, do not mention this to Fatima, as Fatima hadithat ahd bil wilada. She just gave a birth and she's, you know, her health need to be stable, not to give her this bad news. The Prophet did then, as usual, he done adhan in his right ear and iqama in his left ear, as this action will give protection of the child from shaitan, as becomes sunnah. We follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. When we give a newborn baby, we give him adhan in his right ear and iqama in his left ear. The other narration states that Jibreel has brought to the Prophet the soil in a jar at which Imam Hussein will gain shahada. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi has given that jar to Salama and said, when Hussein killed, the soil in this jar will turn red. And this is again is a famous narration which shows actually the emphasis of shahada of Imam Hussein. In addition to the Prophet who mentioned the shahadat of Imam Hussein many times, and there are many narrations talking about the shahadat of Imam Hussein by the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, Imam Ali alayhi salam also, when he was going to Siffin, in his way to Siffin, he passes through Karbala and he told his companions what will happen on Imam Hussein and his Ahlul Bayt and companions on the day of Ashura. On another narration, he told Ibn Abbas and said to him, if you know what will happen, you will cry as I am crying. So Imam Ali started crying and he said to Ibn Abbas, if you know what will happen, you will cry as I am crying. And he asked Imam Hussein to practice sabr on that occasion, meaning the occasion on the day of Ashura. Imam Hussein himself, when Ibn Abbas tried to convince him not to go to Iraq, he said, this is the will of Allah to see me killed. Sha'allah an yarani qatilan. And then when he asked him about the ladies of Ahlul Bayt, why he's taken, he said, this is the will of Allah to see them captive. Sha'allah an yarahunna sabaya. What all these narrations telling us is that the issue of uprising of Imam Hussein alayhi salam is a plan from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that his religion requires sacrifices to reform the nation of the Prophet by Imam Hussein alayhi salam, and this eventually leads to the establishment of justice at the hand of the 12th Imam, Imam al-Hujja ajallahu ta'ala farajahu, who's the ninth from the progeny of Imam Hussein alayhim as-salam. As I mentioned at the beginning, it's some of the titles that has been given to Imam Hussein alayhi salam. One of them is At-Tabi' ila Marratillah, the one belongs to the pleasure of Allah. As we know that the Imam alayhim as-salam, they are the utmost example in manifesting the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we mentioned many times, and gaining the acceptance and the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, their aim all the time. That's why when we discussed this morning, we said Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say abd to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. And one of the main character of abd is atta'a, obedience to his master. And a real abd is the one who obey his master all the time, with all occasions, irrespective how difficult these occasions are. And this is manifested by Imam Hussein alayhi as-salam. Salli ala Muhammad wa ala
Muhammad.
Of course, in one of the verses of the Quran say, وَالَّذِينَ يَشْرُونَ أَنفُسَهُمْ ابْتِغَاءَ مَرْضَاتِ اللَّهِ. If you correct me, Abu Murtada, on this verse, which is revealed when Imam Ali alayhi salam has sacrificed himself by staying in the bed of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi, ومن الناس من يشري نفسه ابتغاء مرضات الله. Among the people, those who sell their nafs, their soul, in the way, in order to get the acceptance of Allah, the rida of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if Imam Ali alayhi salam has sold himself in order to get the acceptance, the rida of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he slept in the bed of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, knowing that Quraysh was at that day intending to kill the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, and he was about to be killed, that Imam Hussein has not given just himself, he given himself, all his family, all his companions, and he has subjected the family, the ladies, to the captivity to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The other title mentioned in to Imam is Ad-Dalilu ala Dhatillah. He's the one, is the proof on the essence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we know very clearly, without the Imams alayhum salam, we could not understand the proper tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. However, Imam alayhum salam not just explained to us tawheed, they practiced tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in every aspect of their life. And what Imam Hussein has done is the utmost example of tawheed. Tawheed, that means submitting himself, his family, whatever he can do within his capacity in the way of his Lord, to sacrifice everything in order to save the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of the nice saying of Imam Hussein during his uprising, he said, "An-nasu," describing how people, and he started saying, "An-nasu abidu dunya, wa-dinu la'iqun ala al-sinatihim." People are slaves of dunya, and religion is like a lick on their tongues. يَحُوطُونَهُ مَا دَرَّتْ مَعَايشِهِمْ. They surround the religion, they are very close to religion, as long as their materialistic interests are satisfied, as long as their living, their safety, everything satisfied with religion. Yes, they pray, they perform hajj, they do ziyarah, everything. فَإِذَا مُحِّسُوا بِالْبَلَىٰ. If they are tested in calamities, the religious people would be reduced. فَإِذَا مُحِّسُوا بِالْبَلَىٰ قَلَّ الدَّيَانُونَ. The number of those people who adhere to religion at the time of calamities are very few. And it's always, we can see it, we say it, we've seen it in our time, at the time of Saddam, when he was like threatening everybody, praying, you go to the mosque. Nobody, everybody fearing actually going to the mosque because of Saddam. A lot of people, they showing that they practicing something against the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in order to save themselves from the tyrant. And this happened all the time. Imam alayhi salam, of course, has given this ultimate example of being on the right path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even when he ended facing a huge army by handful of people. He got few people, 72, whatever different riwayat. This is the common number. And facing at least 30,000. Again, the number may differ, but 30,000. So this small army to face that huge army of Yazid, of Bani Umayyah, in order to save Islam. Imam Hussein knew very well that he's going to be killed. Even at the last moment of his holy life, when his holy body was full of injuries. You know, Imam Hussein alayhi salam, at the last moment when they throw him with all things and his heart was bleeding and he was sitting on the ground, looking at all his companion has been killed, looking at his son Ali al-Asghar has been killed on his lap. What Imam Hussein has said, and this is very important, it shows it reached a status where it's very difficult to be patient at that moment. Most of the people, they will be like they lose their control at that moment. But what Imam Hussein has said, he said a long dua, but I pick that word, which is a key. He said, "Hawwana ma nazala bi innahu bi'aynik." What made it easier to bear what happened to me is that it is in your sight. Said, what happened, whatever calamities it happened to me, it's make it easy for me to bear because I know you are looking at me. So whatever is happening, although apparently it's a calamity, but there is khair in it. And that's Zainab alayhi salam has said that to Ubaidillah when she said, "Ma ra'aytu illa jamila." I haven't seen anything but a beauty. Saying that because she can see the what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has give them in terms of reward in the hereafter. They know that they will suffer in this dunya, not for their own sake, but the sake of Allah. Imam Hussein has done everything for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Of course, we as a human being, we are weak. We cannot reach that level of proximity to Allah. But if we truly love Allah and Ahlul Bayt, we need to struggle in His way, in the way of Allah, and in the way of the Ma'sumeen alayhim salam, by being closer to them, by not by talk only, but by our action. It's easy to say it, as I am saying it now, but it's difficult to apply it. But we have, as a mu'mineen, inshallah, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inshallah, to give us tawfiq, to struggle in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to please Allah and to please our ma'sumeen, because they are the way towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we know, if we want to see the path towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have to adhere to their words, to their actions. Well, I'll end up my talk with this dua. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد اللهم اجعلني مع محمد وآل محمد في كل عافية وبلاء واجعلني مع محمد وآل محمد في كل مثوى ومنقلب اللهم اجعل محياي محياهم ومماتي مماتهم واجعلني معهم في المواطن كلها ولا تفرق بيني وبينهم إنك على كل شيء قدير السلام عليك يا أبا عبد الله التي حلت بفنائك عليكم مني سلام الله أبدا ما بقيت وبقي الليل والنهار ولا جعله الله آخر العهد مني لزيارتكم السلام على الحسين وعلى علي بن الحسين وعلى أولاد الحسين وعلى أصحاب الحسين جميعا ورحمة الله وبركاته اللهم صل على محمد
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد أحسنت بارك الله فيكم بارك الله فيكم
أحسنت الله جميعا
أحسنت
إن شاء الله we see you all tomorrow إن شاء الله Agha Mushtaq, are you around?
Yes, I've been listening to your talk, sir.
You never know, maybe you have some commitment. As Agha Murtaba, he had some commitment, he has to go to work. Yeah, I just wanted to know that what time shall we have the work today?
Whatever time suits you.
Shall we say same time?